tide shift, you're actually seeing people beginning to understand that they've been hoodwinked,
yeah.
that their government is lying to them, that they're involved in situations that they cannot get out of. And so it's happening across, and by the way, this is all going to affect the realpolitik, because once they realize how badly they've been fooled, then they're going to react. And when they react, it's going to go to the other extreme, which is they're going to go to the extreme where they don't buy anything they're being told.
Yeah.
That's what we want. That's the beginning of enlightenment.
That's right.
To move to that other extreme. So it's happening right here in this country right now. I've been watching it, fascinated by it. Right now, the polls that they take are showing that people just by leaps and bounds are not believing anything that's going on anymore.
Yeah.
And it's at that moment that we can change things.
Yeah.
That moment where they're unsure, that we can come in and say, hey, here's what's really happening. You know, this world is deeper and more complex and more of a manifestation of our mind and our spirit than you ever dreamed of. And yes, it is like a holographic universe, and each person is a part of the hologram.
Yeah.
And if each person changes, the hologram itself changes. And so it's an individual thing, and it's a mass thing, and a collective thing, and it's all happening at the same time. And I think that I like to always say that, you know, you have to go to hell before you go to heaven.
Yeah.
The reason that you have to go to hell before you go to heaven is because if you just go to heaven without going to hell, then you can't appreciate what heaven is.
Exactly.
But if you go to hell first, and then you go to heaven, then you can appreciate how nice it is once you get there.
Of course.
I think that's what's going on here, is we're in our own hell, and we're beginning to realize that's not a place that we want to live in.
Yeah, yeah, I totally agree. And you're correct, you have to have reference points to know where you're at, basically, in this holographic universe, then, because there's so many facets to all of this, and there are multiple ways that we can go here. We're about 8 minutes away from the ending of our first segment here, but you want to, you know, return to the book and maybe mention a few more things about it?
Yeah, so let's see here. Where do I go here? Okay, so this book is really just trying to take popular culture and reveal the alchemical reality that is the truth of who we are. And I try to use pop culture because everybody can identify with pop culture.
Yeah.
I realize, of course, that this is what Stanley Kubrick and J.R.R. Tolkien and even James Cameron and Bergman and a few others, not very many, to be honest with you. There aren't a whole lot of filmmakers who are actively pursuing this kind of thing in a conscious way. There are many who are pursuing it in an unconscious way and may not know it, but for those that are actually seem to be conscious of it, they have created these films, and there's details in the films which seem to show that they know what they're doing all the way.
Yeah.
And I think that's what's more intriguing to me than anything else is little tiny details inside the films that shouldn't be there. They don't really help the story or anything, yet they're there nagging at you and saying, hey, look at me, you know, what am I doing here? And then you look at it, you say, hey, you know, this is really weird.
Yeah.
And then you look at it and you realize, of course, that they did know what they were talking about. Stanley Kubrick never told anyone what he was really doing in 2001, A Space Odyssey. And I wrote my essay in 1999 and actually came out finally again in the year 2000, revised. And I got a letter from the producer, Bob Watt, of 2001. He said every day on the set, he asked Stanley what this film was about. Stanley would never answer him, right? And then Christina Kubrick, his wife, wrote me and said that, you know, you are right. Stanley was obsessed with alchemy, and Stanley was obsessed with the Kabbalah. You know, then I knew that he wasn't an atheist, as everyone was saying. He just didn't believe in the kind of God that was being foisted on us by society.
Yeah.
And this is evident in other films, like The Shining. It's obviously a film about reincarnation, which is a strange thing if he's an atheist. And I just actually met Malcolm McDowell a couple weeks ago, who was the star of A Clockwork Orange. And Clockwork Orange is an incredibly prescient film about, in fact, even the title, which it means, you know, what something organic, it looks organic on the outside, it looks like an orange, but inside it's filled with clockwork, and it's like a machine. So, you know, what he's saying is that, you know, we're becoming machines, and if we're not careful, we will be machines. And of course, Stanley was obsessed with this idea that if the human race doesn't change, it's going to become machine-like. This is what Hal was.
Yeah.
And this is also in the film that he never finished, but Spielberg finished, AI, or artificial intelligence. This is what it's saying. And and so there's this kind of downwardness into the downloading of the human soul into the machine that I think Stanley thought was the greatest nightmare of all, in which I completely agree.
Yeah.
It is the greatest nightmare of all. But Stanley also shows us that it's not going to happen. In 2001, he shows us that there will be a transcendent moment before this is allowed to happen, at which, you know, man becomes the superhuman, man becomes the star child, and returns to Earth to change the world.
Yeah.
And so, ultimately, you know, 2001, A Space Odyssey, is in fact the most optimistic film ever made. What's interesting about this is that 2001, the year, which was 33 years after Stanley made the film, turned out to be probably one of the most important years in the history of the world.
Yes, indeed.
Not just because of 9/11.
Yeah.
Because of a lot of other things.
I mean, and listen to, I mean, even The Two Towers, the Lord of the Rings movie came out. I mean, the first movie came out 2001, the second 2002, and I mean, it isn't at all far apart here.
No, it isn't. And you know, there's all these other uncanny things. The supposedly, if you believe the government, you know, the first thing, the first building that they, the terrorists supposedly targeted, was the UN building, which is a black building and looks just like the monolith.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
It's like, huh? You know? And then you look at some other things which are quite disconcerting about 9/11. One of the which no one ever mentions, is that the three main symbols of Freemasonry are the two pillars,
yeah,
Jochem and Boaz,
yeah,
and then the third one is a pentagon. And on every Freemasonic initiation chamber, that's what you have. You have the two pillars, and then you have on the wall a pentagon.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
This is exactly what was struck on that day.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's just like, what does this mean? Why is it... Why did it happen, and why doesn't anyone ever talk about it?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, there's so much interesting stuff here. And Jay, I think that would be an excellent cliffhanger to end this segment in, basically, here. But in the last minute or so, why don't you tell people how to get your book and so forth?
Yeah, well, the book, Alchemical Cinema, is not out yet, but if you write to me at jweidner@sacredmysteries.com, I can line up a copy for you when it comes out. And if you go to my website, jaywidener.com, you can read all my articles on Tolkien, on Kubrick. They're all there for free, and you can look at some of my other stuff. I've got a very good article about 2012 called The Topology of Time.
Yeah, excellent.
And I think then you can get a better idea of what it is that I'm saying. And if you're interested then I would really highly recommend you get my film Secrets of Alchemy and then go read the book Mysteries of the Great Cross of Henday.
Yeah.
So then you won't think that I'm a complete wacko. I might actually have done some research here.